I've been surfing in internet about Web 3.0 to know what it's all about, to be able to break it down for you guys to be able to understand. So at the same time, I've been also scrutinizing to a very high degree to be able to give you my own critique, so you could be able to understand what Web 3.0 is all about. So if you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe and turn the bell notification for me and smash the like button as I begin. I also want to let you know that if you want to double all your money, okay, I make predictions on the channel, and this is the reason why you should mostly subscribe to the channel. Whenever you hear any, then you know that it's me making a prediction, because I have some other team that also helps me to make videos. So make sure you subscribe and turn on the bell notification, smash the like button, and God bless you. So before I share my reflective on what Web 3.0 is all about, we are going to go from Web 1.0, Web 2.0 to Web 3.0. But let's use Web 3.0 first as an introduction, so you could be able to understand what I am talking about. So Web 3.0 has been floating around the internet, and Web 3.0 is predicted the new phase of the internet evolution. Web 3.0 aims to build a new decentralized internet where users own their own data and apps run locally, which means that you and I could be able to have control over our own data. And computer scientists and internet experts believe that these changes is going to be able to make the internet to be more smarter and also our lives easier. And I think that this is really a good concept. And aside from all, I'd like to go back to Web 1.0. So we could be able to talk more about this, so you could be able to comprehend, as well as you having all the full overview, so you could be able to envision. Web 1.0 refers to the fourth stage of the World Wide Web evolution. Back then, there were only few content creators in Web 1.0. Perhaps you're already wondering what I have here on the screen. If you check on Web 1.0 to Web 3.0, right on a column rather, you will see that in 1996, we only have the web, okay? And the web was more like a read-only web, in a way that people could only read through web pages and be able to share information within themselves. And we have about millions of users back then, and Web 1.0 was more like an ecosystem, and people were able to connect information. Along the same line, Web 2.0 was already under development. Then in 2006, then we started using Web 2.0, and I'm really happy that we were able to hit the mark. So everybody started using the internet, and since then we've been able to use Web 2.0. And example of Web 2.0 is Google, Facebook, YouTube, and some other social media you already know, Twitter and some other ones, because you could be able to interact and make more friends and all of that. But because during 1.0 time, there wasn't any chance for that. So as you can see, we can be able to read and write, and we could be able to interact, and we have billions of users who are using Web 2.0, which is the future we are in right now, and people could be able to connect and all of that. Web 2.0 here, so let's use YouTube as an instance. We've been able to have a lot of content creators, and we've been able to also be making money as a content creator. YouTube pay me for this video and all of that, and I think that's really good. So now the reason why people and the future is going to be switching over to Web 3.0 is because of few problems we are having, because we want to be able to have, like, be in control of our own data, and not just that, we want to be able to create something that is going to be so good in a way that people could be able to interact and be able to walk hand to hand, not just hand to hand. We don't want to be locked up in a room and be told on what to do, okay? So people want to be able to have that full control. There should be a great alignment, okay, to this. Moreover, everything is going to be so anonymous, to understand that everybody's profile is going to be kept on private, because you are the only one who is going to have only your data, and you only know yourself and nobody knows you. So you, if you check on the Web 3.0, you will see that they want everything to be a read and write and execute web in a way that people could be able to understand itself, and people could be able to connect knowledge and share knowledge, and not just there, people could be able to have massive freedom to whatever they want to do. And I'm going to be leaving a link of this PDF down in the description for you, so you could go check more about what it's all about, and this will help you. So have it in mind that everything I've said on here is only from my own experience, okay? And also, I want to let you guys know that Ethereum, Cardano, Polkadot, and also Solana, they are also enhanced together for this development. And not just there, guys, immediately we all together hit the mark on having 3.0 decentralized internet, what will happen is that all crypto are going to be on a huge bullish movement. And not just that, most of all these coins are going to be used as a payment gateway, and most of these coins are going to be used for the most part as a currency on the decentralized internet. And that's why I feel that you guys need to also keep on bagging most of the coins which you think that are still on a value at the moment, because this will help you so you could be able to be maybe 100x richer by then, or you could be the top richest. And I feel that the world is changing, and we need to make sure we adopt this particular web 3.0, because this is the only future that we need, because we cannot be locked up in our room no more. So let's add hands together, smash the like button, subscribe, share this video to all of your friends so we could be able to build this family together, and see you on the next one.